This is Roger Pafford. We're going to calibrate the BenQ SW2700PT monitor using the XRite I1 display colorimeter and BenQ's version of XRite's Palette Master Element software. The BenQ SW2700 is a true 10-bit monitor. It's factory calibrated to display 99% of the Adobe 1998 RGB gamut. Its native resolution is 2560 by 1440 pixels. It has a 10-bit color depth, and its 14-bit lookup table allows it to produce over 1 billion colors. The pixel pitch on this 27-inch monitor is 0.21 millimeters, and there are 110 pixels per inch. The monitor includes a hardwired control, or puck, that permits the user to choose between Adobe RGB, standard RGB, and black and white screen settings. The controller also allows access to an on-screen display menu, or OSD menu, allowing the user to choose additional pre-programmed screen settings. These include REC 709, DCI-P3, and a photography setting. Custom calibrations are stored in either Calibration 1 or Calibration 2. This is the splash screen for BenQ's version of the Palette Master Element software. Today, I am calibrating this monitor using the XRite I1 Display Pro. Other colorimetric devices are listed here, including Data Color's Spider colorimeters. When the Check Sensor button is selected, the XRite I1 display will begin to flash. I've chosen advanced settings and will start the calibration now. Two options are shown on the workflow page. We will begin by profiling the monitor. This is the display settings screen. There are four default settings: photographer, web design, graphics, and cinema. I'm going to leave this on photographer for now. The white point is set to D65. The RGB primaries is set to Adobe RGB. I'll change this to standard RGB. You should use the primary that is best suited to your workflow. Luminance is set at 160, gamut at 2.2, and black point is set to absolute zero. The XY mode gamut diagram is showing you the CIE 1931 chromaticity gamut. The white triangle shows you the standard RGB color space. The U' V' gamut diagram shows the CIE 1976 uniform chromaticity scale. This is the measurement page. This measurement screen shows that we are using Calibration 1 for our custom calibration. This is where you can choose to use one of the two available slots for storing your custom calibration. The ICC profile will be assigned to your calibration. It will contain the name of the monitor, calibration information, and today's date. You can make this information available globally by checking this box if there is more than one user profile on your workstation. The profile version is set to version 4. Profile type is set as matrix. It seems I get a better result choosing a 16-bit lookup table rather than matrix or 8-bit lookup table. I changed my patch set size to large. A good result can be had with the small and medium patch sets as well. Here you see the small patch set, the medium patch set, and the large patch set. To begin a calibration, click Start Measurement. The software will show you how to prepare your colorimeter. After clicking Continue, a measurement window will appear with the silhouette of your measurement device. You should place this over the shadow and allow the counterweight to drop neatly behind your monitor. The colorimeter needs to rest against the screen so that the device does not move or turn during calibration. You can adjust the counterweight and the face of this device to ensure it does not tilt. Click Continue and the measurement will begin. The calibration process includes writing a lookup table, followed by measuring all of the color patches, and then, again, writing a second lookup table before the validation step. The measurement process today took 18 minutes. You can shorten this by choosing a smaller patch set. I compress this into a shorter sequence for your convenience. The calibration report shows that the monitor achieved a luminance of 158. The target was 160. The target temperature was 6,505 Kelvin. The measured temperature was 6,506 Kelvin. Now we will validate the calibration. Click Calibration. Again, the Prepare Your Sensor dialog appears, directing you to expose the colorimeter optics for measurement of the screen output. Click Continue, and the software will perform a 15-patch validation measurement. The validation report shows that the best delta E was 0.07, the maximum delta E was 0.92, the average 0.27. If we run the validation again, we should achieve similar results. This time the average delta E is 0.31 and the maximum is 0.95. As both validations report maximum and average values less than 1 delta E, we can expect the represented colors to appear indistinguishably close to their lab values. This completes the calibration of this BenQ SW2700PT monitor using the XRite I1 display colorimeter. I hope this has helped to answer a few questions that you might have had when learning how to calibrate this monitor.